Blessed be. Blessed be. God thank you.
Damn, that's cold.
Well, just how cold is that brewski, Handyman?
Brewski's 34 degrees. That's one I didn't finish. We'll take care of that.
So why? Yeah, that is the question. Why do you mark up materials, and who's going to see these numbers? What you're doing is just overcomplicating something that's extremely simple. I'm going to use a real-world example. I have another job coming up where I'm replacing an old window. I know I'm going to need a new window, flashing, joint compound, some tape, that's it, some fasteners, maybe some shims, and some wood to pack the size out correctly. I know what those things cost. That's one number. Write that down. How long is it going to take me? I don't know. Could take me 2 hours, could take me 4 hours, but what's the market value of that job? My customers aren't going to pay some idiot that doesn't know how to install a window $50 an hour and take 20 hours to do it. They expect it done that day. That's the market value. That's the industry standard. They expect it done in a half day. You're not going to make any money if you're doing work in a half a day and charging by the hour. That's another thing. I highly discourage charging by the hour. So the market value of that window replacement is $1,000. That's all the customer sees. That's all the customer needs to know. That's all you need to know. If that fits into your expenses, your budget, your life plan, then this is a good business to be in. Okay, let's just break it down. The window costs about $130. And we'll go on the high end, $50 in other materials. So that's $200. Write that number down. And then subtract it from 1,000. That's $800 you make for that window. The customer only sees one number. See, $1,000. That's it. They don't need to know how much your materials are or how much you're marking them up. I understand this is some old school thought of marking up your materials to justify your expense to the customer. No, there is a market value for home repairs and home remodeling. That's what you have to work with. In some places, it's much less than other places. The market value of replacing that window. But yeah, you can expect to pay $20,000+ to have all your windows changed on your house. So don't get caught up in overcomplicating the estimating process. I've always kind of preached, you gotta know what the market value of your services are in your area. Then target customers that value you more than somebody else and target those customers in that area. They place a higher value on the service, the customer service that you give, not what you're charging. They're willing to pay you more to have you in their house, you installing their windows instead of somebody else. What happens if you get into a situation, say you're new and you got some random person saying,
"Hey, I heard you do some handyman work. I need a new window replaced on my house. I want to know how many hours it's going to take you, or what's your hourly rate, and how much the materials are, and I want it all broke out on a schematic, on a spreadsheet."
You say,
"Yeah, you heard wrong. See ya."
And go the other way. When I started out, I specifically only worked for customers that I knew I could knock it out of the park. What I mean by that is exceed their expectations. Without a doubt, I knew that they were going to be happy customers. And I think it's common sense that when you get somebody that is already showing signs of overanalyzing and micromanaging the cost of the job, things aren't going to go well. They're just not going to go well. And I stayed away from them. Today, somehow, I don't know, I got to brush up on my blurring effects on my videos. Today I got an email from someone saying, "Hey, we watched your videos on YouTube. We know exactly where you live. We've got a townhouse down the street that we want you to remodel." And I'm like, no, I'm not on YouTube to promote myself at all. So the only way I will work for someone is if they have been recommended to me by a previous customer. And that's just to get to talk to me. And it's not an arrogance thing, it's a business thing. Because a lot of you guys that have been in the business a long time have shown in the comments that you agree with this, that you don't do advertising anymore. because you get too many tire kickers, and it's a waste of time. And that's why I always promote and recommend that you use your customers to do your advertising. Previous happy customers to recommend you to their friends and family. It's the only way to go. The rest is going to be low pricing. Sure, you might get a good one out of like 50. It just wasn't worth my time, and I knew that it wasn't going to lead to the network of customers who will never ask how much
does that window cost? How much does that light fixture cost? How much do those outlets cost?
They don't ask. They just know the job's going to get done. Back to the material markup. I think it's pretty clear that it's just a waste of time, and you should not be showing your customers that the item costs $14, but you're charging $20. It just doesn't get broke out like that. It's not well received by customers. Unless you're like partially retarded and can't do basic math, there's no need to say, okay, I'm going to the store to buy a light fixture. Now I gotta get out my calculator and figure out a markup for that. No, it's your time. You bill for your time. It's $100 an hour or $20 an hour. Some guys are working for $13 an hour.
Down there in Mississippi.
And you charge for that time to go get materials. If you're doing hourly, like I said, I discourage hourly, you do need to know how much time it's gonna take you for your scheduling. But you can never charge more than what the value of the project is. I mean, you can charge within a little bit of room on the high end, but generally, you're only gonna be able to charge what the market will allow. So I just don't understand that there's just no reason for it. You're gonna get paid top dollar for the market value of that project. Let's discuss, and share your experience. Don't take it from me. I'm wearing flip-flops and a gun with blue handle, and I got a pot on my workbench that I boil heads in.